Welcome to this tutorial, where I want to teach you how to design transitions in After Effects, how to make them reveal themselves. I'll also show you a real example how you can easily use them and how to render the project to use it outside of After Effects. A lot of interesting stuff to cover, so let us start. At first, I want to create a new composition. I'll hit the New Composition button and I'll create an HD composition, 30 frame rate, with 5 seconds of duration. This time we will work with the polygon, so go to the Tools tab, click and press on the Rectangle tool, and select the Star tool. I select the Star tool, and I'll try to create a star in the middle. By holding the Shift key, I make sure that it will have perfect proportions. Alright, this star doesn't look as good, but we can always go inside the polystar and change things up. Now, select the color you would like the transitions to have. For example, I will prefer to go a deeper blue, maybe a navy blue like that, or I'll stay with the teal, this will be alright. Now I can adjust the polystar. At first, I would like to open the polystar run, the polystar path, and definitely make more points for it, because I want a completely different look. Let's maybe make 12 or 13 points, this will look optimal for the things I want to achieve. Now I want to make this slightly bigger here on the edges. We can adjust the size of it by working with the inner and outer radius of the polystar. I will adjust the inner radius to an amount of about 270. This should be okay as I look on it here. And the outer radius I'll raise to about maybe 500, maybe 550 will be okay. We can always adjust that later. Now, watch how amazing it is to work with native Adobe After Effects tools within the program. This being a polystar doesn't mean we can add more things to it. And that's what shape layers are all about. We can add, for example, an ellipse on top of it. Now I want to make sure that it will be within the polystar one because I want to merge them. So I select the ellipse I just created and I move it into the polystar. Now I can click on the ellipse. I have the ellipse pad here. I will open it and I make its size bigger, to about this degree. Now we don't see it yet because it is not filled out. To make it filled out, I need to move it above the stroke and above the fill, because else the hierarchy will not work. The hierarchy in After Effects is from top to bottom. I have the ellipse created, but I want to intersect those objects here. So once again, I click on add, and now I add the merge path. I put the merge path right behind the ellipse path. I open it up and select the mode instead of add to intersect. Now we are getting closer to the object we want to achieve. I still would like to have filled those items here, so I need to add one more ellipse. And that's really beautiful to work like that, because you can add vector items within the software. So I click on the merge path because I want to edit behind it, add another ellipse. The ellipse should be behind it, because I don't want it to be merged. I want it to be added, and I work with the size. The size should go about here. And I believe we have our object ready. If you need any adjustments, always go to the polystar and we can change the sizes, so it will be looking a bit different. This is the object I want to work with. Go into the timeline and close everything down. Now I want to make sure that it's perfectly in the middle. I click on the object, I go to my align panel, and I select this icon and this icon to center it. If you don't see those icons, then you can find the align tab. Now we can finally work on the transition. I'll open up S for scale, and by pressing the shift key, I also press R for the rotation. On the scale and the rotation, I'll set keyframes. At first, the scale should be 0%, and depending on how long I want the transition to take, I'll place it at about 1 second and 50 frames. We can see it here. I want the scale to be much, much bigger, so it covers the entire screen. Apparently, it's about 400%. While doing so, I also want it to rotate maybe 180 degrees, so it's not too quick, not too slow. Let's preview the animation. Yes, this looks pretty nice. Now what we have to do, this will be really simple, because we can click on the shape layer, click Control or Command if you are on a Mac, D, D, D. So we have four objects. Let me go a bit forward. The second object will be placed in the right corner. The third object will be placed in the left corner. And the last one will stay in the middle just as the first was. Please select the second and the third and maybe change their colors, just so it isn't so boring. I'll stay within the blue range, just so it's slightly visible that those colors are different. I press OK, and this is how this animation basically would look. Okay, that's a bit too boring, so we need to stagger the layers. I'll select the layer, I press the left Alt or Option key, and I select Page Down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, maybe 7 frames forward, this will be okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I want to be somewhat precise here, so it really looks cool. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All of them, by pressing U, have the same keyframes, so we don't have to animate it manually, because we animated it in the beginning. Now we see how this transition will look, and the animation is already very interesting, but we lack some closure. I'll show you a great trick in After Effects. Select all those layers, right-click on them, click on Pre-compose. I'll call this composition Transition Animation. I have this transition animation. Now we have all those objects within one composition. You can always go back and change things up here. Click on this pre-composed composition and click again Ctrl+D to duplicate it. I'll call this, by pressing Enter, I can change the name of this layer. I'll call this Reveal. And I'll show you why, because I can place this forward by making sure that modes are visible. By clicking the second button here, you can use the modes. I'll select the mode Silhouette Alpha. What Silhouette Alpha does, it reveals the layers with the layers. So as the animation, the second animation will start here, it will start to reveal itself. I see this is too close. We can go forward. Okay, and now we can preview our finished transition. Okay, this looks really beautiful. You can go a bit forward so it isn't so quick. So the video has time to reveal. I would even risk to go a few seconds forward. And this is a perfectly prepared transition we can use for any video. I'll check when the transition ends. At about 3 seconds and 50 frames, this transition is finished. So I press Composition, Composition Settings, and I change the duration to 3 seconds and 50 frames. And this is a perfectly prepared transition for use in any video. Now you can select those two pre-compositions and pre-compose them once again. I select a shortcut, Ctrl+Shift+C, but you can also right-click and pre-compose. Use this animation. This is a ready composition you can use anywhere. Let me show you an example how easy it is to use such transitions. I've imported some example footage, and let's say you are working on a video. You are doing something and you want to reveal one video with another video. So I have video number 1 and video number 2. I place this one forward and the first video is playing, and then the second appears because I'm editing something. I can transition between them by simply dragging and dropping. Use this animation here. Place it as the first one, so it will be visible, and place it in the proper moment. And that's it, you are ready. The first video plays, the transition effect appears. Oh, sorry for the sound, I need to mute it. And then the video is revealed. If you want anything to, for example, be quicker, take less time, I can right-click, Time, enable time remapping. By having time remapping enabled, I can time remap so it will take quicker to play. You see, it will end here, so I place it a bit forward, and now I can preview once again the effect. The first video plays, the transition goes in, and the second video is revealed. Also a cool thing is that you can double click on the Use This Animation, you can add it to the render queue by selecting Composition, Add to Render Queue, and in the Output module, you could select QuickTime Video, and in the channels RGB plus Alpha. This would render a transparent video, which could be used in other software. because this animation, as you see by this, it's transparent. I can toggle the transparency to showcase what I mean, so it can be rendered and used outside of After Effects. This is like the core, the basis of creating transitions in After Effects. Since you now have the basic knowledge about how to design such transitions, I hope you will be more interested in After Effects and would like to learn more. If you will be curious how to design more of such transitions, I can follow up with the next video showing you cool new designs and ideas. My name is Andrzej Pach, and I hope you did like my tutorial.